Hey folks, how's it going? I'm bored. I'm actually driving up north, heading for the border, Bukit Kayu Hitam. And I'm actually driving the Bluebird U12. Yes, it's her first long shakedown drive and she's doing miraculously well. So happy. Really, this car, I mean, I'm doing 110 highway speed limit. And the NVH is still good. I'm in fifth gear. The revs are down at 2,700 RPM, 110. I've covered already 207 kilometers, and the fuel is just down by a quarter. Really, for a 1.8 carbureted, not even fuel injection. Very impressed with this car. Really, 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 really awesome. Amazing. And the fact that the car is more than 20 years old, and it's still able to keep up with traffic, keep up with the flow. When it comes to overtaking up a hill, just downshift, accelerate, it's smooth, no problem. The temperature is stable, got the aircon going, it's nice and cold. Wow. So anyway, I thought I'd play a game with you. Let's do the car pronunciation game, okay? Like A-U-D-I, Audi. Everybody says Audi, Audi, Audi. But you know what? It's actually Audi. Yeah, Audi. It's Audi, yeah. Of course, the luxury arm of Honda is Acura, not Acura, it's Acura. And moving forward, let's go alphabetically, BMW. how do you mispronounce BMW? Okay, you can't, so let's keep going. Then it's Chevrolet, okay, for C, it's Chevrolet, not Chevrolet. I hear a lot of people say Chevrolet. No, it's Chevrolet, lay, at the end is a lay, not let. Although it ends with L-E-T, and you pronounce L-E-T as let, it's not Chevrolet, it's Chevrolet. Okay, don't ask me why, okay? I didn't create the company. Anyway, okay, what else do we have? Okay, there's Daimler, there's Datsun. I'm trying to go alphabetically. Oh, I forgot! The Italians, yeah? It's Alfa Romeo. Yes, you must say it with an Italian accent. That's for the most effect, it's Alfa Romeo. I was actually at a media drive once in Italy. Not for an Alfa Romeo, it was for a Ferrari. And the guy, the host, was actually talking to us and he said, oh, what cars do you drive? And a couple of the other media were there and they were saying Ford and Proton. And when it came to my turn, I actually said it, he's Italian, I actually said it as Alfa Romeo. And he was very impressed. He looked at me and he started laughing and he goes, for a moment you sounded Italian. I said, yes, I know, when I say my car's name, I want to sound Italian because it's an Italian car, you know? It's an Alfa Romeo. Yeah. I wish I could talk to Valentino Rossi, you know, because he's got the most pronounced Italian accent out there. Yes, the bike was very good. Yeah, around a turn 2 and a turn 3. Yes, I was feeling very fast. I got the bike set up beautifully. The mechanics all do a beautiful job, yeah. Down the back straight, I think I need a little bit more top speed. I don't have enough top speed. But the bike is handling a beautiful. So yeah, I want to meet Valentino Rossi one day and I want to talk to him like this. Hey, Valentino, welcome to Malaysia. Have you tried the nasi lemak? Sorry, like I said, I'm bored. So anyway, moving along, what other cars do we have out there that most people mispronounce their names? Of course, you know, Ferrari, you got to say it with an Italian accent. It's Ferrari, yeah. Same with the Lamborghini. Yeah. So let's go with the Italian cars right now. So we got Ferrari, Alfa Romeo, Lamborghini. You have to say it like that with a passion because those cars were built with passion. So you got to say the car name with a passion. Okay. Okay. German cars, Volkswagen. A lot of people say Volkswagen. Yes, that's correct. It's Volkswagen. But if you're over there, it's actually pronounced as Volkswagen. 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 People's car. Get it? Okay, what else do we have? Okay, we've done BMW. Okay, we've done Mercedes-Benz. Oh, we didn't do Mercedes-Benz, but kind of difficult to mispronounce Mercedes-Benz. I mean, it's Mercedes-Benz. Although the short form, this is interesting. The short form for a Mercedes-Benz is Merc, not Merce. Although it makes sense because it's Mercedes-Benz. So you would actually say Merce, but no. The short form pronunciation is Merc. The same with Porsche. Some people say Porsche, some people say Porsche. So I'm not sure which is the right one actually. I've heard the correct pronunciation is Porsche. Porsche. But many people here say Porsche. I don't know. Potatoes, potatoes, tomatoes, tomatoes, who cares? what else? Sorry, third gear.
Watch out, vehicle stopped on shoulder ahead.
I wanted to go into fifth and I went into third. Toyota, okay. I mean, the Japanese cars, not really much you can mispronounce because they're Asian and, you know, we are Asian, so it's very easy to pronounce their names. Mitsuoka, Honda, Toyota, Nissan, Datsun, Suzuki. Very hard to mispronounce those names. I think it's the European and American names that we tend to mispronounce. Like earlier I mentioned, it's Chevrolet, not Chevrolet. What else? Buick, Dodge. Very, very easy to pronounce. I would reckon the French cars. Okay, Citroën. A lot of people say Citroën, and that's fine. Citroën. But it's actually Citroën. You got a Citroën. You know, can you do that without spitting? I don't think I can. I think I just spit on myself. So yeah, it's Citroën. And for Peugeot, we always say Peugeot. It's Peugeot. Yeah. You must say it with a French accent. Because the French have a beautiful accent. Just like the Italians. The French have a beautiful accent. And when they say Peugeot, it sounds so sexy. Instead of Peugeot. Peugeot. For God's sake, don't say Peugeot. Peugeot is wrong, okay? It's Peugeot. So you say it, you think of the French food, and you think of the French wine, and you go the so Peugeot, you know, Peugeot, Citroën, yes, that's how you say it, Citroën. You see how sexy it is when you say it in the correct pronunciation, yeah. Oh, speaking of correct pronunciation, I got a car joke for you. Okay, bear with me, okay, I got a car joke for you. Car jokes are few and far between, so bear with me. So five guys in an Audi Quattro are driving along and they get to the Italian border. And the border patrol says, sir, I'm sorry. Oh, sorry, that's French. You cannot pass. You cannot pass the border because you are driving an Audi Quattro. And Quattro means four. So you can only have four people in your car. And the driver was like stumped. He was like, what the hell are you talking about? Quattro is the four-wheel drive system for this car. It doesn't mean I can only have four people in my car. That's ridiculous. And the border patrol guy is like, no, I'm sorry. You cannot cross because you have five people in a quattro. So the driver's like pissed. He goes like, you know what? I'm not going to talk to you. You're a moron. Bring me your supervisor. Bring me the commanding officer here. I want to talk to him. And the border patrol guy says, I'm sorry, I cannot do that because he's very busy. And the driver asks, why? Why is he so busy? And the border patrol guy says, because he's over there arguing with two guys in a Fiat Uno. Okay, get it? Uno, dos, tres, cuatros, one, two, three, four. Fiat Uno. Uno means one, the two guys in the car. So he's arguing with the two guys in the car because they are in a Fiat Uno. Yeah, okay, I'm bored. Okay, wait. Hey, give me a break. Car jokes are very few and far between. So anyway, what's the time on this? Oh, 8 minutes. Okay, so I'll do another 2 minutes and then I'll call it quits. So what else? What cars out there do you think that are being mispronounced? If I missed anything and you've already thought of something that you want to know the actual pronunciation for, put it down in the comments and I'll get to it. But of course, in the comments, it's going to be very difficult to impart sound. Yeah, sound is going to be a bit difficult. You know, I got to stop doing that because it might stick. You know, like, you know, you're making a funny face and somebody slaps you at the back of your head or on your back. Your funny face stays with you for the rest of your life, yeah. So, I got to stop doing the Italian accent, eh? Because it might stick with me for the rest of my life and then I'm in big trouble and I'll just have to go and live with Valentino Rossi. Yeah, okay. Hey, NRNR. Great, I need a break. I'll talk to you all soon. Thank you for watching. Yeah, I gotta keep remembering to say that. You know, I really am thankful when you watch. So, thank you for watching. I'll be back soon. Bye. I need to pee.